In the 1800s, American coinage saw quite a few different denominations introduced, some of which seem rather silly at first glance. Who needs a 2-cent piece when you can just use, well, 2 cents? Turns out, they all had a good reason at the start. A 2-cent piece was proposed in 1806 and 1836, but making a copper coin twice the size of large cents wasn't reasonable. Instead, it was to be made from billin, a composition of 10% silver and 90% copper. Neither proposal passed. The switch to small cents in 1857 made a 2-cent piece more reasonable, and the start of the Civil War created a greater need for them. Northerners, afraid that paper money and government bonds would lose their value if the war went poorly, began hoarding precious metal coinage. This hoarding became so widespread at the start of the 1860s that there was a shortage of circulating small change. Individuals and companies began creating what are known as Civil War tokens to facilitate commerce. The Coinage Act of 1864 allowed for 1- and 2-cent coins made from bronze. The goal was to get as much small change into circulation as fast as possible, and it was just as easy for the mint to strike a 2-cent piece as it was a cent. Before the act was passed, two different patterns were considered for the 2-cent piece, one with a bust of George Washington and one with a shield, both by James B. Longacre. Both designs featured an option for the new national motto, which was suggested in 1861 by Reverend Mark R. Watkinson. He believed that the warring country needed a motto tied back to God, so Longacre suggested God and Our Country on the Washington pattern, and God Our Trust on the shield pattern. This was modified to become In God We Trust, a motto now found on all of our coinage. The first 2-cent pieces were released in 1864 and were generally accepted. Almost 20 million were minted in the first year, but demand and mintages decreased every year of their production. Nickel coinage was introduced soon after, and it circulated well. By the end of the 1860s, it was clear that the 2-cent piece was no longer needed. The last ones were made for circulation in 1872, and a very small number of proof issues were minted in 1873, marking the end of the 2-cent piece. However, hoarding during the Civil War wasn't the first time that America faced a shortage of circulating coinage. In the late 1840s, most silver coins left circulation due to exchange rates, and large cents were unpopular and didn't circulate much. When the postage rate was dropped from 5 to 3 cents, the idea of a 3-cent piece gained traction. To have a reasonable size, the mint chose to use a billin composition of 75% silver and 25% copper. It contained less silver than its face value to discourage melting, but was also the first step toward devaluing the nation's coinage. The first silver 3-cent piece was minted in 1851, and they were initially popular because they were the only small change available, but this didn't last. They came to be strongly disliked because they were so small and easy to lose, bend, or stain, and were generally considered unattractive. They were also frequently counterfeited because the small size enabled crude workmanship to go unnoticed. They became known as fish scales. The introduction of small cents in 1857 made them less necessary, as cents were more accepted. In addition, they fell victim to hoarding during the Civil War. Hoping to get 3-cent coins back into circulation, the mint began producing nickel 3-cent pieces in 1865, and minted both compositions through 1873, when the silver issues ended. The main purpose of the nickel 3-cent pieces was actually to enable people to redeem 3-cent fractional notes for hard currency. Many of these notes had been released to facilitate commerce during the Civil War, but the mint wanted to get them out of circulation. By the 1870s, most had been redeemed and mintages declined. The introduction of mechanical vending machines spelled trouble for the 3-cent piece, as they were similar in diameter to dimes and could confuse the machines. The biggest nail in the coffin, however, came in 1883, when the postage rate dropped to 2 cents. 6 years later, in 1889, the nickel 3-cent piece was discontinued. Overall, the 3-cent piece lasted for almost 40 years, much in contrast to the 20-cent piece. The shortest-lived denomination in American history, it was only minted for circulation for 2 years, plus an additional 2 years of proof-only issues. It was suggested as part of our original circulating coinage back in the late 1700s, and was debated alongside the quarter. The quarter won out, and it wasn't until an 1874 proposal by Nevada Senator John Percival Jones that the idea of a 20-cent piece gained traction. He gave multiple reasons to justify it. Base metal coins didn't circulate out west, so when the silver half dime was discontinued, they faced a shortage of small change. It was thought by some that a 20-cent piece would make it easier for Westerners to give exact change. In addition, there was an organization known as the Latin Monetary Union that had gotten the government's attention. Many countries, originally all in Europe, had agreed to mint coins with the same metal content and equivalent values to make trade between countries easier. This was similar to today's euro, but based on precious metals. The 20-cent piece would fit perfectly into this system in weight and value, enabling the US to take advantage of easier trade, even if we didn't fully join the Union. This same idea is what led to the $4 Stella gold piece of 1879 and 1880. However, the motivation behind the 20-cent piece was also selfish. Profit. After the Coinage Act of 1873, the mint no longer accepted silver to be minted directly into coins, leaving silver miners at a loss. Adding another silver denomination would mean the mint needed to purchase more silver. Conveniently, Senator Jones himself owned a silver mine. The idea was ultimately accepted, and after many different patterns, a seated liberty design was chosen and the first pieces were released in 1875. However, they were not the magnificent success the mint had hoped. They were shockingly similar to quarters and ultimately led to far more problems than they solved, as they were constantly mistaken for quarters. They came to be known as the biggest flop in U.S. coinage history, and legislation was introduced to abolish the denomination the very next year, though the last 20-cent pieces were minted in 1878. None of these odd denominations made it out of the 19th century, but they give us an interesting picture of what commerce was like in the U.S. at the time. It's a world unfamiliar to us in an age of credit cards and online payments, but in a young country torn apart by war, the mint had to scramble to find a way to get money to circulate. Small change was critical for everyday purchases, and these unusual coins were their answer.